Hallelujah and blessings in Jesus, friends. Welcome back to Hayakadosh Ministries, where holiness is a way of life. Jesus is truly King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and the Holy Bible is the only standard for truth. Well, friends, today is September the 12th in the year of our Lord, 2017, and this is One a Day for the Soul. Friends, in a world of chaos, war, ISIS, natural disasters, political disasters, and moral values being compromised on every degree that we can think of, Jesus is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And you must remember what he said. When you see these things coming to pass, lift up your head, for your redemption draweth nigh. And what that means is, do not allow yourself to focus upon the things taking place on this world, because Jesus, hallelujah, is on the throne. And that's what our text today is going to remind us of. Now, this is a prayer offered by King David as he's handing the kingdom, the rulership of the people of Israel and Jerusalem, over to Solomon. And it says in verse 10, "Wherefore David blessed the Lord before all the congregation. And David said, Blessed be thou, Lord God of Israel, our Father, forever and ever. Thine, O Lord, is the greatness, and the power, and the glory, and the victory, and the majesty. For all that is in the heaven and in the earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Lord, and thou art exalted as head above all. Both riches and honor come of thee, and thou reignest over all. And in thine hand is power and might, and in thine hand it is to make great and to give strength unto all." Now let's back up and look at verse 11, because that is so full of power, friends. "Thine, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory." Don't let your eyes be taken by what you see happening on this earth. Don't let your heart be burdened by what is taking place. "For God, the Almighty, the Most High, the Ageless One, He is the power, and He is the glory, and the victory, and the majesty." You see, men have deceived themselves into thinking that they have some kind of power, that they hold some kind of rule within their hands. But it is God who is the power. It is God who is the glory. It is God who is the victory and the majesty. "For all that is in the heaven and the earth belongs to Him. He is the kingdom, and thou art exalted as head above all." Look at verse 13. He continues his prayer. "Now therefore, our God, we thank thee, and we praise thy glorious name. But who am I, and what are my people, that we should be able to offer so willingly after this sort? For all things come of thee, and of thine own have we given thee." What am I, says David, a mere worm in thy sight, and yet you shower your blessing and your favor upon me and all those who call upon your name. "For we are strangers," in verse 15, "before thee, and we are sojourners." We don't belong to this earth. This isn't our kingdom. We are pilgrims passing through, friends, as were all our fathers, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Moses, Joshua, Caleb, Elijah, and all the fathers of the faith, the previous servants of God. Our days on the earth are as a shadow, and there is none abiding. Look at verse 17. "I know also, my God, that thou triest the heart, and hast pleasure in uprightness. As for me, in the uprightness of mine heart, I have willingly offered all these things." What have you given to the Lord lately, friend? And now have I seen with joy thy people, which are present here to offer willingly unto thee. God always has a remnant. No matter how dark this world seems, God always has a remnant who are willing to exalt him and praise him. For he is the greatness. He is the power, friends. He is the glory. And the victory is within his hands. He only is slack in his promise because he is giving all men an opportunity to repent of their ways, to turn to him, and to live under his rule. Because he is the king of heaven. He is the king of the earth. And all that is in heaven and in the earth belongs to him. And he will be exalted above all others. Every knee will bow. Every tongue will confess that Jesus truly is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And again, together, the people of God say, Hallelujah, Hallelujah. Friends, do not be dismayed, but as Jesus said, lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. Now, as he wills, and until next time, friends, I love you, and I'll see you on the next video. Thank you.